Hello everyone. In the earlier video, we have discussed about what is the meaning of alternating current and alternating EMF, and we also have tried to derive the relationship between the IRMS value and ERMS value, and what is the relation between the RMS values of current and peak value of alternating current, and also what is the relation between the RMS value of voltage to the peak value of voltage. In the similar video, we have also discussed about the meaning of the phasor diagram and how the phasor diagram helps us to simplify or to analyze the AC circuits in a simple way. Now, today in this video, we are going to discuss about the different types of AC circuits. Now, in this particular video, we will be trying to derive the voltage and current relationships for individual as well as the combined circuit elements such as resistors, inductors, and capacitors carrying a sinusoidal current. Now, here, let us first talk or discuss about AC voltage applied to a resistor. Now, suppose that you consider a resistor whose resistance is R and it is connected to an AC source of EMF whose instantaneous value is given by E is equal to E naught sin omega t. Here E naught is the peak value of the voltage and omega is the angular frequency. Now let us assume that E is the potential drop across the resistance. Now, by applying Ohm's law, we can write that E is equal to I into R. If we try to rearrange the terms and try to obtain the relationship for the current, we get I is equal to E upon R. Now we know the value of E and we can write the same equation as I is equal to E naught sin omega t upon R. If we consider E naught upon R as I naught, the same equation can be written as I is equal to I naught sin omega t. Now, when you compare the equation for EMF and current, we have E is equal to E naught sin omega t and we have I is equal to I naught sin omega t. So, if you compare these two equations, we can clearly say that for a purely resistive circuit, that is when there is only a resistor connected across the circuit, the value of EMF and the value of current, there is no phase difference at all, or we can say that the phase difference is zero. So the values of alternating EMF and alternating current, they are in phase, which means that both the E and I values, they reach to the maximum, they go to the minimum value, they reach to the zero at the same time. So which means that for a resistor, there is no phase difference between the instantaneous alternating current and instantaneous alternating EMF. They are in phase. Here in this slide, you can see the graphical presentation for the same. On y-axis, we have plotted the values of I naught and E naught, and on x-axis, we have plotted omega t. So here graphically also, you can see that the I naught and E naught, that is peak value of alternating current and EMF, it reaches to the maximum value at the same time, which indicates that there is zero phase difference in between the two quantities. Now, let us try to understand it more with the help of a phasor diagram. In the AC circuit, which consists of resistor only, the current and the voltages, they are in same phase, and hence both the phases for current as well as for EMF, they are in the same direction, making an angle of omega t with respect to horizontal, that is the OX. And if you try to see the projection of these phases on the vertical axis, then you will come to understand that these projections on the vertical axis, they give their instantaneous values. And the phase angle between the alternating current and alternating voltage through the resistor is zero. Now, once we finish with this, we will be talking about AC voltage applied to an inductor. Now here, let us consider a circuit wherein we have connected a source of alternating EMF to a purely conductor. Let L be the conductance of this coil. Now let us assume that the inductor that we have connected here in this circuit, it has a negligible resistance, and therefore the circuit is purely inductive circuit. Now suppose the alternating EMF which is applied or which is supplied in the circuit is represented by E is equal to E naught sine omega t. Now here in the circuit, when the key K is closed, the current begins to grow in the conductor because of the magnetic flux which is linked with it. It changes and the induced EMF is produced, which opposes the applied EMF. And this happens in accordance with the Faraday's law, which we have studied in electromagnetic induction chapter. Now, if we apply the Lenz's law, then we can write the equation as E is equal to minus I into di upon dt, where di upon dt is the rate of change of current and E is the induced EMF. Now, to maintain the flow of current in the circuit, what you need to do? An applied EMF E must be equal and opposite to the induced EMF. And according to the Kirchhoff's voltage law, as there is no resistance in the circuit, this EMF should be equal to minus E dash. So let us substitute the value of that, and we can write the equation as E is equal to minus of minus L into di upon dt. Minus of minus, it gets plus. So we will have E is equal to L di upon dt. If we rearrange the terms, we can write the value for current as E upon L into dt. Now, if we integrate this equation on both sides, we will be able to calculate the total amount of current flowing through. So, integrating the equation on both sides, we have integration of dl is equal to integration of E upon L into dt. We know the value of E as E naught sine omega t. So, we can write this as I is equal to integration of E naught sine omega t upon L into dt. Now, applying the simple laws of trigonometry and doing the integration, we can write I is equal to E naught upon L into minus cos omega t upon omega plus constant. Now, this constant of integration is time independent and it will be having the dimensions of current. Now, this constant of integration comes out to be zero. So, we can have the equation for current as I is equal to minus E naught upon omega L, and this cos omega t we can write in terms of sine as sine of omega t minus pi by 2. Now, if you just concentrate on the term E naught upon omega L, and if you substitute I naught equal to E naught upon omega L, the same equation can be written as I is equal to I naught sine omega t minus pi by 2. Now, if you compare the equation for alternating current with the equation for alternating EMF, it will be clear to you that the alternating current or the value of alternating current, it lags behind the alternating voltage by phase angle of pi by 2 radians or 90 degrees. or in other words, we can say that the voltage across the inductor, it leads the current by phase angle of 90 degrees or pi by 2 radian. This is a graphical representation for the same. If you look at the wave which represents the EMF and the current values, it is pretty clear that the voltage is leading the current by an angle of 90 degrees or pi by 2 radians. Let us have a look for the phasor diagram of the same. The phasor representing the peak EMF E naught, which makes an angle of omega t in the anti-clockwise direction from the horizontal axis. Now, as in this particular circuit, that is purely inductive circuit, as the current lags behind the voltage by 90 degree, the phasor which represents the value of alternating current, it is turned clockwise with the direction of alternating EMF as shown in the figure. Now here we have to talk about one particular term which is called as inductive reactance. Now what this inductive reactance is actually? Let us try to have an idea. The opposing nature of the inductor to the flow of alternating current is basically what is known as inductive reactance. Now if you compare the equation with the equation of Ohm's law, that is I naught is equal to E naught upon R, and we have the earlier equation as I naught is equal to E naught upon omega L. So if you compare that equation with the equation of Ohm's law, we will come to a conclusion that omega L is the quantity which represents the effective resistance offered by the inductance whose inductance is L, and that inductance is known as inductive reactance, which is denoted by XL. So here we can write XL is equal to omega L, where omega is frequency, and we know the value of omega. We can write it as omega equal to 2 pi F. So we can write the value for inductive reactance as XL is equal to 2 pi F into L, where F is the frequency of the AC supply. Now from this equation, we can conclude that the function of the inductive reactance is absolutely similar to that of the resistance in a purely resistive circuit. And this inductive reactance is directly proportional to the inductance, that is L, and it is directly proportional to the frequency of alternating current. Now thirdly, we need to discuss about the third combination of the circuit in which AC voltage is applied to a capacitor. So here we are going to consider a capacitor with capacitance C, which is connected across an AC source of EMF whose instantaneous value is given by E is equal to E naught sine omega t. Now when the current is flowing in the circuit, this flow of current is going to transfer the charges to the plates of the capacitor, which produces a potential difference between the plates. Now as the current reverses its direction, we are talking about alternating current. So in case of alternating current, the current reverses its direction in each half cycle, the capacitor is alternately charged and discharged. Now if you suppose that Q is the charge on the capacitor at any given instant time t, then the potential difference across the plates of the capacitor will be given by V is equal to Q upon C. Now this equation we have studied in electrostatics, so we can write the equation for charge as Q is equal to C into V. Now if you have to talk about the instantaneous value of current flowing through the circuit, current is nothing but rate of flow of charge. So you can write I is equal to dQ upon dt, and because we know the value of q in terms of c and v, we can write I is equal to d upon dt of cv. And here v is nothing but the instantaneous EMF, so we can write I is equal to d by dt of c into e. Now we know what is the equation for the instantaneous EMF, so we write I is equal to d upon dt of c into e naught sine omega t, where c is the capacitance of the capacitor. If you take out the derivative by using trigonometric rules, we get I is equal to c into e naught cos omega t into omega. By rearranging the terms, the same equation can be written as I is equal to e naught upon 1 upon omega c sine of omega t plus pi by 2. We can write cos omega t in terms of sine as sine pi by 2 plus omega t. Okay, so we can conclude from this equation that the amount of the current flowing through the circuit will be maximum when sine omega t plus pi by 2 is equal to 1. So if sine omega t plus pi by 2 is equal to 1, the amount of current, peak value of the current, will be equal to instantaneous value of current, that is I will be equal to I naught. And this I naught, if you have the value of peak value of current as I naught is equal to E naught upon 1 upon omega c, the equation for the instantaneous current can be written as I is equal to I naught sine omega t plus pi by 2, where I naught is E naught upon 1 upon omega c. Now again, from this equation, if you compare it with the equation for instantaneous EMF, we can conclude that in an AC circuit which consists of purely capacitor, here the alternating current, it leads the alternating EMF by phase angle of pi by 2. And here is the graphical presentation for the same. Let us try to understand it in details about the phasor diagram. The phasor representing the peak EMF, which is making an angle of omega t in the anticlockwise direction with respect to the horizontal axis. Now, as here the current leads the voltage by pi by 2 radians, the phasor representing the peak value of current, it is turned 90 degrees anticlockwise with respect to the phasor representing the EMF, alternating EMF E0. The projections of these vectors on the vertical axis, they will be helping us to find out the instantaneous values of alternating EMF and current. Now let us try to get the idea about what we actually mean by capacitive reactance. Now here we have tried to derive the equation for instantaneous current as E naught upon 1 upon omega c into sine omega t plus pi by 2, and we have assumed that I naught, that is peak value of current, is E naught upon 1 upon omega c. Now if you compare this equation with the Ohm's law, as I naught equal to E naught upon R, we conclude or we find that the term 1 upon omega c, it is equivalent to the effective resistance offered by the capacitor. And this effective resistance offered by the capacitor to the flow of current, it is known as capacitive reactance, and it is denoted by XC, where C is the suffix. So we can write XC as 1 upon omega C, and as we know omega is equal to 2 pi F, we can write XC is equal to 1 upon 2 pi F into C, where F is the frequency of AC supply. Now remember, the function of capacitive reactance in a purely capacitive circuit is to limit or to have the control on the amplitude of current, and it is exactly similar to the function of the resistance in purely resistive circuit. Now, this capacitive reactance, you can see from the equation that this capacitive reactance, it varies inversely with the frequency of alternating circuit, and also it is in inverse relation with the capacitance of the condenser. And if you are going to talk about DC circuits, as the frequency is zero, the value of capacitive reactance will be infinity. Now, let us try to get some comparative study about resistance and reactance. But before that, let me tell you the SI unit of inductive reactance and SI unit of capacitive reactance is same as that of the unit of resistance, which is nothing but ohms. Now, as I said, let us have some comparative study about resistance and reactance. So when you talk about resistance, resistance is equally effective for AC as well as DC circuits. But when you talk about reactance, in this reactance term, the current is affected, but the energy is not consumed, which means the heat is not generated in case of reactance. Now, when we talk about resistance, its value is always independent of the frequency of alternating current. And when you talk about reactance, the inductive reactance is directly proportional to the frequency. And in case of capacitive reactance, it is inversely proportional to the frequency of alternating current. Also, when you talk about resistance, the current opposed by a resistor is always in phase with the EMF or voltage applied across. But when you talk about reactance, current opposed by a pure inductor, it lags in phase, while current opposed by a pure capacitor, it leads in phase by pi by 2 radian over the value of voltage. So this is how we discussed about how alternating EMF applied across pure resistor, pure inductor and purely capacitive circuit works, and how the values of current and EMF are related to each other. In the next video, we will be talking about AC circuit containing all the three, that is, we will be talking about LCR circuit. Thank you.